Hello friends, you're with the Lonesome Gamer, and I'm playing Successors. Well, we're just through the first round of the first turn, so not a lot happened. But we can already see that there are, well, the players claiming their empires. The black player wants to install an empire in Greece and Asia Minor. The yellow player has kind of a deal with the black player and says, okay, I give you most parts of Asia Minor, but I can keep the southern parts, Egypt, and then I'm going to try to settle here on the islands, maybe, or here maybe on the Levante. The red player will go for this part of Asia here, Armenia, Media, maybe Mesopotamia, Syria. And the blue player sucks. We got to see that, because they are so far apart, they will end up having trouble. I'm pretty sure about that. I mean, for now, they control Thrace, the land of the Tribali, and down here, Babylonia and Susiana, which is good, and they have a lot of victory points right now. But for the future, I see they will have a lot of trouble. But we'll see about that. So for now, the red player goes first. And he managed to bring Zeleucus into play during his first action. He was very lucky that he has drawn that card. So we come now to the surrender phase. That means he's allowed to place a control marker here. Another one right there. Oops. And there we already have one. Okay. Then we flip our next Taiki card. Cilician Pirates. That would give us a fleet. That could be a good idea. Okay, I think for now, I want to play this four-pointer here. So let's see. And this is an event. So I have to play that card now as an event. Let's see what that is. A minor rate and 2 points. It's a bonus card. Remove any one control marker from a minor city space within 2 MPs of one of your armies. Only a space that contains no enemy CUs or independent armies may be targeted. That's not terribly helpful, I'm afraid. Within 2 MPs of one of your armies. Well, I don't want trouble with the black guy, so I'm probably not going for Cappadocia. Shit. This is away 3 MPs, and that's not a helpful. Okay, anyway, my rules force me to do that. But before I do this, I have to play the points. So I'm going to place political influence, one in Zidon and one in Tyre. Now I control Phoenicia, That gives me 2 victory points. And in addition, it gives me the Phoenician fleet. Okay, and then, well, not sure what to do. I think actually the only one I can remove is this one right here. Yeah, every other control marker is actually out of reach from my army, so I have to remove this one in Melitene. Yeah. I wonder if I could remove the one in Paphos. I'm here. That's within 2 MPs of one of your armies. I think I could actually move this one. Yeah, I think I will do that. You can use any type of path except Transmediterranean. That would be 2 MPs here. It doesn't say I can't jump over anything. So I'm going to remove the one here in Cyprus. Okay. And then I'm going to go for my movement phase. And I definitely want to grab Heracles in my movement phase. To get there, I need to move 3 spaces. So I would need a 4 at least. And that sucks. That allows me to move only 2 spaces with, or 2 movement points with every general. So yeah, that wasn't great. Okay, let's see. Craterus. He's got a pretty good army here. What about this guy, Ptolemy? Well, he's not quite as good. So we don't have to be afraid. This guy doesn't have to be afraid of him, I guess. So I think I actually want to move. Could move to Tyre or to Emesa. I think I want to move to Emesa. And with this guy, I'm simply going to move to Amida. And here I think I'm going to move to Pasargadae. Okay. And that's it then. Well, actually, you know what? No, it's fine. I could not move with him any further. Okay. I guess I'm fine. Yeah, I think I want to take one of these guys here, grab a minor general, and I start with both of them here, move with one guy here, and with the other one down here. I think that's a better idea, and save some time that way. Okay, the yellow player. Now let's see what we got. Mass migration of Illyrian tribes. Well, the Illyrians All right, here, and we could send them. We could send this neutral army and cause some trouble in Macedonia that way. But for now, I think I'm fine playing the Greek mercenaries. Oops. And I cannot do that. Instead, because I rolled a 4 here, I have to play this card, the mass migration of Illyrian tribes. Okay, So I think the yellow player will also simply place political influence markers. And Well, I could only place one here in Gaza. Or here, yeah, 3. I think I want to place one here in Halicarnassus, which gives me control over Caria. That gives me another point. And I also gain the Asian fleet here. So I already have 2 fleet points. If I gain another point, I would have the biggest fleet, and in that way, a 3 additional victory points. Then I want to place another marker here, Xanthus, and I want to place one in Gaza, I guess. And finally, we can play this mass migration of Illyrian tribes. And yeah, it's the Illyrians are now activated if they have not been already. You may move the Illyrians plus all other activated independent armies up to 3 movement points. Okay, so the Illyrians are here. And yeah, where do I want to move these guys? Okay, now we can move the Illyrians, we can activate them, and we can move all already active armies. And the Greek army down here, and the Cappadocian army over there, they already start activated. So that means I will move these guys. I can move them up to 3 spaces. I'm going to move them here. And then if they end their space on an enemy, if they end their move on an enemy controlled space, they can remove the control marker there. So that's simply what I'm going to do. No more effect here. Over there. Oh, no, that's not possible. Exactly, I want to move these guys. I cannot remove the control marker in a major city, only in a minor city. So I think for now, let me see. I think I want to activate the Greek army first. And I want to move with these guys here and attack Antipater. Now there are restrictions. The Greek army can only move in Greece and Thessaly, but yeah, well, Thessaly is still fine. So we're going to move in here. The Greek army has a strength of 6 and a battle rating of 3. Now Antipater has a battle rating of 3-2. You can see here the yellow number, or the number in the yellow box, but he only has an army with a strength of 4. So he might consider avoiding battle. So he's got this initiative rating here on the left, the 3. If he rolls above that number, then he is allowed to avoid battle. Now let's see. Yes, he can. So I guess what he wants to do is, he might, yeah, he wants to unite with the minor general over here. He can move up to 2 spaces, by the way. When you avoid battle, you can move up to 2 spaces. But in this case, I think 1 space is enough. Now, do I want to follow him? I could. I still got 2 movement points left. I mean, why not? You know, it's a... There's nothing to lose here for me. So I wanna try to attack him again. And this time Antipater is willing to fight. He's got the better odds. So let's see. I'm gonna show you now how battle works. So first we check the battle strength of the attacker. That's a 6 in this case here. And we gotta roll 2 dice. Then we have this battle rating here of the leader, the 3. And that shows the minimum number you roll on a die. So let's assume I would roll a 4 and a 2. Then I could change the 2 into a 3. Because the 3 here is my minimum number that I will roll on each die. So we got a battle rating of 6. Now let's see. Okay, that's a 6 and a 3, so that's a 9. And now let's see, we got here the battle table. This is our battle rating. And we have a 9, so that means we have a, well, let's call it battle number or combat number or whatever, of 5, which is not too bad, I guess. So now it's Antipater. And together with his other Macedonian troops here, they have a battle rating of, or a combat strength of 8. His battle rating is also 3. So let's see what they have. That's not so great. He can change this one. This die into a 3 because of his battle rating. So he's got a 7. They got 8 troops. 7 makes it only a 4. So that means the attacker has a 5. The defender has a 4. That's pretty bad because it means that Antipater has lost the battle. The consequence of that is, he would lose all mercenary units, but lucky for him, he doesn't have any. In addition, all the Macedonians, including Antipater himself, are placed into the dispersed box. So I'm going to bring these guys in here and mark them with a black marker, just to remember that they belong to the black player. And then we have to roll for attrition. Now we got 4 units here, and we roll here on the attrition table, and that's a 1. That's a very lucky here. So as you can see, there is no effect. So that means in the end was just a rout. No real losses here, but Antipater is dispersed for now, so that means he only can come back in the next turn, which is pretty bad. Okay, the Greek army, because it's an independent army, as long as they win, they don't take any losses at all. Okay, and then we still have the Illyrians to move. And I kind of want to simply move them here, I guess. to Paconia, remove that marker, and that's pretty much it. Not too great for the black player here. Okay. Okay, now it's the yellow player, and he can do his movement phase now, and he could do a really dicky move here. I mean, he could say, okay, fuck our agreement, I'm gonna attack the black player. Now that this guy is gone, I could simply do an attack against him. I could, for example, make a coalition with the blue player at this point, attack him, and the blue player could attack here, and the black player would be just in a terrible shape. Of course, that would cost the champion status for the blue player, for the yellow player, and the blue player. And especially for the blue player, that might be a problem. The yellow player, he doesn't have any royal units. He already is the usurper, so he can get attacked by anyone without any problems. He's in the lead in victory points, so for him it could be a real option to do that. Still, what I did is I came up with some personalities. I know now people can see I'm a real nerd, you know, I mean, but I want to try that. And you can see here I made simply basically two important values. One is, are people more passive or aggressive players? And the other one, will they be loyal to their treaties or not? And if we look down here, the yellow player, well, I simply rolled two dice for everyone, okay? And, well, from a... I rolled a seven would be the middle, right? And the yellow player turned out to be a very loyal guy and also pretty passive. So it is very unlikely that he would do this. Still, I want to give him a chance here. So on a six, I'm going to roll again. And if I roll then a five or six, he will actually go and do an attack here. Although, as I said, very unlikely. Nope. Okay. Fine. So he will honor the treaty. And instead, well, we roll... That's a three, so he can move this general three spaces and this guy two. So I think I'm simply going to move with him to, I don't know, Samaria. And with this guy, I could try... Now, okay. Shit. I think I'm gonna, hard to tell, but I guess I want to move toward Rhodes. Hoping that nobody will attack me if I do that. What are the odds? I'm the usurper, but I have a big fleet, so I can use these two fleets to protect me. In theory, one guy could try to intercept me if he has a control marker on a port space, which is... no more than two spaces away, but that's not the case here, so I can simply move here, try to attack Rhodes. Okay. So the black player, during the surrender segment, gained Hellespontine. That costs now the yellow player 2 points, and the black player gains 2 points. Okay. And then we have, let me see what we can do now. Interestingly, the black player, he rolled double five. He wanted to play the treachery, the card for the points, but he rolled double five, so that means he has to play now the event here, the epidemic event. And it says, target any one army on the map. That army suffers an epidemic and must roll on the attrition table immediately. So, I guess I will target the army of Lysimachos here. He's got four units. And that's a four. So that means he loses one of his units. You can choose which one. So he loses a mercenary. And now I'm allowed to move. Okay, that means I can move four spaces with Antigonos and three spaces with these minor generals. Okay, and another very important decision. Does Antigonos want to attack Lysimachos? Or does he just want to take these two areas here? Or maybe only that one here, to try to gain control over the Hellespont. It's very hard to tell. I'm going to give it 1 to 3, 4 to 6. So a 1 to 3, we'll see an attack. Nope, no attack here. So I remain kind of careful. Simply move here, pick up this guy, and then move here. Okay, let's see. And now I have two movement points left. That is just enough to do a siege attempt that costs me two movement points. And so I'm going to roll on the siege table, which is up there, and we'll see what happens. That's a six, which is awesome, because that costs the other guy 2 points and I don't lose anything. Now, a successful siege of one of these minor independent cities requires only one siege success or one siege point. So therefore, this control marker is removed. I cannot place my own control marker yet, but in the next surrender phase, I definitely can do it. Very good. So the blue player during the surrender phase gains control over the city of Susa and also over the province of Susania overall. So that gives him one more victory point, and he is now even with the yellow player. But the yellow player will remain the usurper until the end of the turn, no matter what. Okay, let me see what I can do with this guy. The red player played the Cilician Pirates, so he also has control over two fleets now, the Phoenician one and the Cilician one. Then he will move here to Damascus, where he gains control over Heracles. This guy is worth 2 legitimacy points. So he's now at 5 points. And by the way, he rolled a 6, so he can move a lot of spaces here, up to 4 spaces with all his generals. This is Seleucus. That's him. Okay, I want to bring a minor leader into play here. So that guy here moves, I guess, to Karana. 2, 3, 4. And Zeloikus moves here. Crossing the mountains costs 2 points. We want to gain control over Armenia. So that's probably the best way to do that. And with this guy, not sure what to do here. We could start pissing off the guy here in Babylon. Why not? Okay, I think for now I will not move down here. I cannot get Susiana without attacking Susa. That would force me to lose my champion status. I don't see a reason for that. It's only a 1 point province. So I think instead I simply will I'm gonna move with all my guys back to Ecbatana. So they built one big army now again over there. Well, it's not exactly a big army, but okay. And maybe I'm gonna try to gain control over Atropatene, and I could play diplomatic cards to gain control over Hyrcania. So that would give me 2 points, and I think that makes more sense at the moment. So the yellow player starts the surrender phase, and he can place here a marker in Zamaria, and he can now do a free siege attempt against Rhodes. This is going to be hard to take because we have a minus one modifier here. So let's hope for the best. Okay, that is a 3. That means we both lose 1 unit. Leonatus. Okay. And he plays a siege 1 marker here in Rhodes. Let's see. I can then play again an event here. Yeah, I think I want to play the Greek mercenaries again. And I can do it. So that gives me 2 mercenaries and a minor general in any friendly controlled space in Greece, Lydia, Thessaly. So I can place 2 mercenaries with one of my generals. That's definitely cool. I'm gonna go here to Miletus. Okay. So I can use this guy to reinforce my besieging army here, for example. Okay, and now we come to the movement action. That is a 1, that sucks. Only 2 points for all my units. Still, that's enough to move here to Rhodes. I can unite him now with Leonatus. Okay. And I think with this guy I'm simply gonna move here. Yeah, why not? Okay, and then I will do. Oh, actually, and then this guy will activate Leonatus and do the siege again. 2 points is just enough for one attempt. And this was good. That's a 5 minus 1. That's a 4. So that means Rhodes takes another hit here. One more. And the island is mine. And that is pretty valuable. It gives me 3 victory points. And a fleet. The black player plays the treachery card. And for 4 points. And he places now this marker here to train some troops. And he wants loyal Macedonians. And for 7 points, he can gain a unit of them. Okay. Then he's going to roll a die. That is a 6. So that allows him now to move here for 1 point. And then he can do 1 siege attempt there. Oh, well, that was awesome. 2 successes. He needs 3 overall. Heraclea Pontica. But still, that's a very good start. No losses on his side. Very, very good. Okay. Yeah. I guess that was the black player's turn. Let's do the blue player's turn, and I think then I'm gonna load it up. Okay, he gets Macedonian reinforcement. Place 1 Macedonian CU with any friendly army or in any unbesieged major city that you control. That sounds pretty good. I guess I definitely want to play that card. Let's see if I'm allowed to. Yes, I am. The only question is, who should get that? Lysimachos or Perdiccas? I think I'm going to give it to Lysimachos. On the other hand, my long-term goal is to move with him through Asia Minor, through Mesopotamia, Asia Minor, to bring Alexander's body to Pellas. So I might actually consider giving it to Perdiccas. Yeah, why not? Maybe that's a better idea. Okay. So, he already has quite an army here. And then we roll for the movement. Now that is very good. That's a 5, so he can move both generals quite a bit. The question is, do we really want to do it? And I could move minor generals. Yeah, I think that's what I want to do. So I'm going to move 2 minor generals. One, two, three, four. This guy moves to Nineveh. And Let me see. The other guy moves to Nisibis. And then in the next surrender phase, I would gain control over Mesopotamia. Okay, so yeah, I think that's then again the end of this round. Obviously not of the turn, we still have two more rounds to go. So in the next video, we're gonna see the end of the turn then, I guess. And then I have to increase the pace. Maybe I can get it to one video per turn, but usually at the beginning of the game, I tend to take a little longer, explain everything in detail and so on. Okay, hope to see you on the next video or on lonesomegamer.com. Bye.